101 programs, we called ours University 101, it could be College 101, those programs really center on relationships and relationship building. And without that, there's almost, I hate to say no reason for such a program, but the reasons become far less significant. I mean, anyone can stand up and tell a student what he or she needs to know in order to be successful. But students will often tune that kind of information out if it's delivered in a lecture format. But it's if it's delivered in a classroom that is built around relationships, where students have relationships with each other, they trust each other, and they trust the faculty member, then again, it's far more likely to take root because of that nature of trust. And yes, we would argue that, especially across the first year, that the classroom needs to be a place that is characterized by strong relationships between students and between faculty and students.
I developed a course called University 101 at the University of South Carolina that was replicated, it has been replicated at hundreds of other institutions, including Elon University, the purpose of which is to provide a very, very positive experience for faculty and staff and students to come together for 4 months or so at the beginning of the college experience. To really change the nature of that transition experience. And, you know, when colleges and universities have the will to do this and when they will devote the time and the attention and the resources, we can dramatically improve the success of the adjustment and transition process into the institution. And, you know, I saw that done in all kinds of ways in the course that I led, but also in hundreds of other institutional settings in the United States and in a number of other countries that have replicated this same concept. And this is about creating groups of 15, 20, 25 students and a higher educator who leads that group, who may commonly is a faculty member or a staff member with significant graduate education. And often these groups are co-led by an outstanding undergraduate student who's been a high achiever and who's made a successful transition, her or himself. And they lead students through a group process where they teach them how to be a successful Elon University student, for example. And what we know from the studies that have been done on these, the outcomes from these courses, is that students who have this kind of an experience, they are more likely to, well, for one thing, they're more likely to stay in college longer. They earn better grades compared to like qualified students who don't have this experience. They are more likely to have joined certain co-curricular organizations that bind them to the institutions. They're more likely to be engaged in certain activities outside of class, service work, attending plays, concerts, lectures, wide range of co-curricular activities. These students provide document higher levels of satisfaction with their beginning experience at the institution. We also know that they even make decisions differently in some areas of their lives.
I think a key question we need to ask ourselves is, who is the course for? I think at a lot of institutions, the course over time becomes for the university. It's the opportunity that the university has, different offices have, to get in front of first-year students and help them understand various aspects of the university, how study abroad works, how Greek life works, how the honor code works. Those are all important things, but that may not be what the students most need out of a University 101 course. If we think about the course as fundamentally for students, they might most need support in transitioning into the university, in thinking about who they are and how they belong in this setting. And that's a space where relationships, where community, where time talking with peers, time talking with other students, time talking with their advisors might be the most important thing, rather than just learning about various aspects of the university. Of course, they need to know both of those things, but what do they most need in this, and who is that course really for?
I would also add that not all faculty find this to be comfortable. You know, there are just some people who are better at relationship building than others, and especially the faculty with students. I mean, I think that some faculty really, they would sort of rather not be too involved with students at a personal level. They don't quite know where the boundaries are. They don't quite know how to have those relationships. So I think that's a real challenge for some folks, and I think we need to acknowledge that and be sensitive to that, but also help faculty learn ways that resonate with their own personalities, that they can, in fact, build relationships with their students.